Hi, here's a tabletop review for my Olympus XA. Now, this is a plastic film camera that they don't make anymore, but it's awesome. And I got mine for $15 at an antique store in El Paso, Texas, which is an incredible deal. The batteries cost like $10 and the camera was like 15. So sometimes on these older film cameras, you can find really good deals, and this was one of them for me. So the operation is your basic rangefinder operation. You do actually have to know how to rangefinder focus with this thing. It does have a very, very small rangefinder window. This is the window for viewing, and this is the window for the rangefinder. So this is teeny tiny. So the rangefinder motion is very subtle, but it works. This is not going to be your precision focusing like a rangefinder, but it's pretty good. And even at f/2.8 on a 35 millimeter lens, I've had really good experience with this. Most everything is in focus when I use the rangefinder accurately. So it's got a cool feature with the flash, just because I want to get the flash off this. So now the flash is on and it'll charge. It works off of one AA battery. I kid you not, one. So it takes a little time for that to get working, and it prefers to be used at a distance of 8 feet for 100 and 16 feet for 400 ASA. There's no kind of in the middle on that one. So it kind of is what it is. This is not exactly the most advanced flash. There's an adjustment over here for full 100 ASA and then 400 ASA. And it does have a sensor, so it will do some things. So it lights up when it's ready to take it, and let's see if I can get. Nope, I'm not completely open it. Open is on. And then wind, and here we go. Okay, so I'm gonna take this off for a second so we can see the camera, because most of the time when I travel and I'm hiking or something, this is what I take. I don't usually need the flash. The flash is nice, but I don't usually need it. So it's a rangefinder operation, and it's got the toggle down here for your rangefinder. Infinity, so you're shooting landscape photos, just set it to infinity. If you want to take close-up photos, I do this and then do the macro walk or dance. So the Advance is like one of those cheap disposable cameras. It's pretty rudimentary. There's no lever, it's just a clicky wind here. The camera's off, the camera's on. That's it. And that's pretty cool. So it's your lens protector and your on-off switch. It won't let you take a picture when it's off, except when the back is open, so you can advance. There's no film in this. Check it. No film. So when the back is open, you can advance all you want, so you can wind your film in. I was a little hesitant, thinking, man, this is plastic gears, plastic everything. But it works, and I haven't had any issue with spacing or anything in this camera. And so, really ultra lightweight. I think the back might actually be metal, but most of this is plastic. So, exposure, your ASA is set here, also known as ISO, but on this camera, everything's labeled ASA. And then you have your options for your aperture priority. So, you can see it's got a four blade, it's actually two components, but four blade aperture. So not the smoothest aperture, but it's functional. And it goes from f/2.8 to f/22. Inside the viewfinder is a meter, and I'll see if I can get a video of that, as a meter over here, and so you can see what your shutter speed will be based off of your aperture. And I found that very intuitive to use this aperture priority, and it it works great. The exposure on this camera is very good, and I've shot slides through it and negative film and color and black and white, and I've been very happy with the results. The lens is actually pretty decent considering the size. So the selling point for this camera is it is incredibly compact, right? Like, my hands are slightly big, but, you know, this is a really small, pocketable camera. I can put this in my pocket and not have to worry about it being too bulky. I can put it in a suit pocket. If I'm inside, throw the flash on. It adds a little bit of bulk, but not too much. It's really light. I enjoy it as a backup camera when I'm hiking, because I'm also hiking with some really heavy camera equipment otherwise. When I take my Pentax 6-7, this camera is a nice 35 millimeter camera to have in case I run out of 120 film, or I just want a backup camera on a different film type. I shoot a lot of black and white through my 6-7, so shooting some color slide or some color negative through this at the same time is great. It's also, for those who are into this sort of thing, if you put it at 2.8 feet and then stop it down, you can get pretty good photos of yourself. If you want to take a picture of yourself and your significant other while you're hiking, this is a lot easier to use at arm's length than a Pentax 6.7. So that's my little brief review on the XA, and I hope you enjoyed it. Here are some slides that I shot with this camera. I was using Fuji Velvia, and this camera really performs with slide film. I was really happy with the results and the amount of contrast that it gives. And the exposure is pretty good too. I didn't have to do much when I was scanning these in. As promised, here's a shot, just a still from the inside of the viewfinder. You'll notice the shutter speeds are on the left side going up to 500th of a second, and there's a little area that has hash marks indicating you're overexposed, so stop down. It works pretty well. It doesn't look so great on this picture because I'm taking a photo through a viewfinder, and your eye will do a much better job than this. It is a small viewfinder, but it's highly functional. This camera is quite discreet, and I think a lot of people like it for sort of a street photography sort of shooting style, but it's applicable for lots of things and lots of fun. So I hope you enjoyed this review, and I'm going to keep posting other classic film camera reviews as I shoot them.